and frosty night coming up. In fact, the frost has already started to form in some areas. If that's not enough, freezing fog patches will probably start to develop later in the night as well, and we've got that frost and ice. The exception really is across Wales and down through in towards the southwest, where we're expecting some rain, perhaps just a little sleet. The more we look at the information coming in though, the more it looks like it'll just be rain. And that's coming in along this weather front here. Elsewhere under the high pressure ridge it is going to be clear. It's still a few showers showing up on the satellite picture, these blobs of cloud running down from northwest England right in towards East Anglia and some close to Northern Ireland. But many of these, I think, look set to fade away into the evening and the first part of the night, leaving sky for most of us, well, almost completely clear. Just that area of rain mainly pushing down through into the far southwest and towards the Channel Islands. Watch out for those fog patches though later on. They could be freezing fog, quite nasty. We're going to have a widespread frost. Now over the snowy areas in Scotland up in the mountains, the temperatures may plummet to as low as minus 10 tonight. So in many northern areas, a really sharp frost coming up. Well, as for Wednesday, we've got high pressure building, pushing away that little low that will perhaps just at first bring some rather cloudy skies and a little bit of rain right down around the south there. That will clear away across into the continent, leaving most areas fine and bright with some rather weakish wintry sunshine coming through. We're also going to have some showers. They're more likely to sound around the east coast, and they may just have a bit of a wintry feel to them, maybe some hail or even a little bit of sleet. Most of them, though, will probably still manage to be rain. Most of us having a dry day then, fine, with some sunshine, but in a few places, some of that fog will linger right into the day and keep it very cold indeed. Much of Scotland and right down the Pennine chain will stay at or even below freezing, and for many, temperatures no higher than 5, just up into the 40s. Over the next few days, though, weather fronts will start to rush in from the northwest, finally starting to lift the temperatures, but at first it'll be cold and fine, later some rain.